One day something lying close to the darning needle glittered so splendidly that she thought it was a diamond. Yet it was only a piece of broken bottle. The darning needle spoke to it, because it sparkled, and represented herself as a breastpin. "I suppose you are really a diamond?" she said. "Why, yes, something of the kind," he replied, and so each believed the other to be very valuable. And then they began to talk about the world and the conceited people in it. "I have been in a lady's workbox," said the darning needle, "and this lady was the cook. She had on each hand 5 fingers, and anything so conceited as these 5 fingers I have never seen, and yet they were only employed to take me out of the box and put me back again." "Were they not high-born?" "High-born?" said the darning needle. "No, indeed, but so haughty. They were 5 brothers, all born fingers. They kept very proudly together, though they were of different lengths. The one who stood first in the rank was named the Thumb. He was short and thick, and had only 1 joint in his back, and could therefore make but 1 bow. But he said that if he were cut off from a man's hand, that man would be unfit for a soldier. Sweet Tooth, his neighbor, dipped himself into sweet or sour, and pointed to the sun and moon, and formed the letters when the fingers wrote. Long Man, the middle finger, looked over the heads of all the others. Gold Band, the next finger, wore a golden circle round his waist, and Little Playman did nothing at all, and seemed proud of it. They were boasters, and boasters they will remain, and therefore I left them. And now we sit here and glitter," said the piece of broken bottle. At the same moment more water streamed into the gutter so that it overflowed, and the piece of bottle was carried away. "So he is promoted," said the darning needle, "while I remain here. I am too fine, but that is my pride, and what do I care?" And so she sat there in her pride, and had many such thoughts as these.